Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and we are going to continue our discussion of the muscles of the upper limb, focusing on the muscles of the arm. So specifically the muscles that have their muscle bellies associated with the arm. So these are going to be three major muscles. There's one other small muscle we're not going to get into here. So this will be the biceps brachii, the brachialis muscle. These will both be anterior. And then the triceps brachii, which is our posterior muscle. Okay, so we're getting into compartments now, and we will really hone in on some of the compartments when we get to the forearm region. But we are going to have an anterior and a posterior muscle compartment of the arm. And most of the time when we're talking arm or upper limbs, when we're talking anterior compartments, we can think of these as predominantly flexors. And in the case of the muscles with the muscle bellies of the arm, we're talking about the elbow joint. So we are flexing the elbow joint. Whereas the posterior compartment of the arm will be associated with extension of the elbow joint. Now we'll start with the most superficial muscle in the anterior compartment, and that will be the biceps brachii. And the biceps brachii is considered a three-joint muscle. And this means that its tendons will cross three separate joints. And so it's unique in that way and will be unlike the deeper brachialis, where the more proximal tendons are going to cross the shoulder joint. The distal tendon will cross not only the elbow joint or the humeral ulnar joint, but also your proximal radial ulnar joint. So these will be the three joints that this muscle will cross. So it can play a role in all three of these, or all three of these joints, specifically in terms of flexion, but also supination. So we'll kind of talk about that right now. So really what we typically think of when we think of the biceps brachii's actions, we think of flexion of the forearm or flexion of the elbow joint. But since it is crossing the proximal radial ulnar joint and is attaching on the radius, and as we recall, the radius is the movable bone when we're talking about those radial ulnar joints, it can also supinate the forearm. So a lot of times it gets forgotten that biceps brachii plays a fairly significant and important role in terms of supination of the forearm. It can also, particularly the long head, play a small role in terms of flexion of the shoulder joint, or more just kind of keeping that joint in place for some of the more distal joints to have more powerful contraction. So it could feasibly play a role in terms of the shoulder joint as well. The proximal attachments are the two different heads of the biceps, and that's where the bi is getting its name. You see the two different heads and two different proximal tendons. Both of these will have an attachment on the scapula in different places, but both scapula. And then those two heads will combine for one common tendon that will attach on the radial tuberosity. So remember that bump kind of just distal to the head of the humerus. That was the radial tuberosity, and it is formed by this attachment of the biceps brachii. And again, recall when we're talking about pronation and supination, it's the radius that's the movable bone. So any muscle that plays a role in terms of either pronation or supination would have to have an attachment on the radius. Now, deep to the biceps brachii will be the brachialis muscle, and you can see its proximal attachment is right around mid-shaft region of the humerus, so not crossing the shoulder joint like what we had with the biceps brachii. And it will have its distal attachment on the ulna, or the coronoid process, and a little bit distal to the coronoid process of the ulna. So, it is not attaching on the radius. So it will not play a role in terms of pronation or supination. It will also be innervated by the musculocutaneous nerve, as was the biceps brachii. Musculocutaneous is one of the five terminal branches of the brachial plexus. And this is a nice example of how one compartment, or this anterior compartment, is innervated by one nerve, the musculocutaneous. And that'll be helpful too. As you're kind of trying to compartmentalize your studying of these areas, I always try to think of the compartments for the big pictures, particularly in terms of innervation. And that way you're not having to memorize separately, say biceps brachii is musculocutaneous and also brachialis is musculocutaneous. You can kind of think the anterior compartment of the arm is musculocutaneous, and that will help in terms of that cognitive load there. This muscle will cross the elbow joint, and actually it is going to be the workhorse in terms of flexion of the forearm. A lot of times biceps brachii gets a lot of the glory because that's our flexing muscle, that's the one that you can see. But this deeper brachialis is really going to be a powerful flexor of the forearm, and particularly in terms of sustained contraction or sustained flexion of the forearm. Okay, moving to the posterior arm or the posterior compartment, and really we only have one major muscle back here that we're going to discuss. So when we're thinking the posterior compartment, we need to be thinking extension. All right. So this will be true in terms of the forearm as well. So that'll be helpful. Anterior for both arm and forearm, think flexion. Posterior for both the arm and the forearm will be extension. It's just what they're extending or what they're flexing will differ between where their tendons are going to insert. Triceps brachii muscle is a huge muscle. You can palpate your own triceps brachii and get a pretty good idea that it's spanning a very large area. As its name would suggest, there are three heads. There is the long, the medial is the one that's a little bit difficult to see. Oftentimes you need to reflect these other ones to see it a little bit better. And then the lateral. And all three of these will come together, similar to what happened with the biceps. So you'll have a common tendon that will have a distal attachment on the olecranon of the ulna. So that point of the elbow, the one that's kind of going in and out of the olecranon fossa, that is where that triceps brachii is attaching. And it makes sense that the olecranon of the ulna is so large because you have this really large muscle attaching to it. I'll come back to this in just a moment, but just again, really the major movement of the triceps, it will be extension of the forearm, so extension of the elbow joint, even though it can play a role in terms of extension of the shoulder joint because it does cross the shoulder joint, at least with the long head. Now, here is an important concept that I really hope that we get and we'll continue to discuss as we move distal. But the triceps brachii muscle will be innervated by the radial nerve. And the radial nerve is another one of those terminal branches of the brachial plexus. And what is cool about the radial nerve is that it is the largest of your terminal branches of the brachial plexus. And it just hangs out posteriorly. And that's great because there are a lot of nerves and there are a lot of muscles. But what's really cool is you can kind of, at least for the arm and the forearm, and there are a lot of forearm muscles, when you think posterior, think radial nerve. Because it is this radial nerve that is going to be innervating not only this posterior compartment of the arm, but also the posterior compartment of the forearm. So I always have people kind of chant back to me, radial nerve equals posterior. Radial nerve equals posterior. I know that seems a little annoying right now, but when you are trying to get your bearings in terms of muscle compartments, it's really cool that radial nerve is doing all of that posterior portion. So, again, I told you I'm not messing around. I really want you to make sure you get this concept. So, radial nerve, which is a terminal branch, in fact, the largest terminal branch of the brachial plexus, is going to innervate which of the two types of compartments in the upper limb? Is it anterior or is it posterior? So chant back, posterior equals radial nerve, right? So that's something that I hope that you understand when we get to the forearm muscle video. That's something you're already going to know because you've gotten it down here. All right. The anterior compartment's a little bit trickier. You're going to have different innervations depending on the arm or the forearm. But what's cool is that both the arm and the forearm posterior compartments are innervated by the radial nerve. All right. Thank you for your time here. We will move on to our next video with all the mini forearm muscles. Fun. Thanks for your time and attention, and have a great day.